हेलो एवरीबॉडी, वेलकम टू जूरी सेंट्रल डॉट कॉम ऑनलाइन क्लासेस फॉर लॉ एग्जाम्स। आज मैं आपके साथ डिस्कस करूंगी दी लेटेस्ट क्वेश्चन पेपर ऑफ मध्य प्रदेश सिविल जज एग्जाम, जिसका जो एग्जाम इस साल होने वाला है, 2022 को होने वाला है। इसके ऊपर मैंने एक डिटेल सेशन भी लिया था कि इस बार की ये सबसे बड़ी वैकेंसी है, जहाँ पे इन्होंने लाइक दे हैव कॉल्ड एप्लीकेशन फॉर दी वैकेंसी ऑफ 123, सो जो कि सबसे ज़्यादा बड़ा है। और इसमें सबसे अच्छी बात यह है कि किसी भी तरीके की कोई नेगेटिव मार्किंग नहीं है। और अगर आप इससे और भी रिलेटेड कोई इन्फॉर्मेशन जानना चाहते हैं, तो आई ऑलरेडी मेड अ डिटेल वीडियो ऑन दैट, इन विच आई डिस्कस द स्कीम ऑफ सिलेबस एंड अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट। तो चलिए देखते हैं ये क्वेश्चन। तो ये जो क्वेश्चन पेपर जो है, ये दी एग्जाम वॉज एक्चुअली हेल्ड ऑन 20th of March 2021, एंड दिस इज दी शिफ्ट टू क्वेश्चन पेपर ऑफ दिस एग्जामिनेशन। सो इसका शिफ्ट वन जो है वो 2020 को हुआ था, और ये एक्चुअली अगर मैं इसके पोस्ट की बात करूँ, सो दिस एग्जामिनेशन इज एक्चुअली फॉर द ईयर 2019, जो कि दो फेज में हुए थे, एक 2020 में हुआ था, एक 2021 में हुआ था। सो आई डोंट शेयर दी आंसर की विथ यू। तो जो लेटेस्ट जो हुआ था, जो 21 मार्च 2021 का जो है, वो मैं आज आपके साथ डिस्कस करूंगी, और जो फेस वन का जो रहेगा वो मैं आपको नेक्स्ट सेशन में डिस्कस करूंगी। सो फर्स्ट लेट अस सी द क्वेश्चंस। लेट मी टेल यू द टोटल नंबर ऑफ 150 क्वेश्चंस, जिसमें से क्वेश्चंस आपके आपके जो डिटेल सिलेबस है उसमें से रहेंगे, एंड प्लस क्वेश्चंस आल्सो विल बी देयर फ्रॉम इंग्लिश एज वेल एज कंप्यूटर नॉलेज। सो लेट अस सी द क्वेश्चंस। क्वेश्चन नंबर वन, दिस इज द क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया। रिट ज्यूरिसडिक्शन ऑफ सुप्रीम कोर्ट इज वाइडर देन द हाई कोर्ट। सो वेदर इट इज करेक्ट और इनकरेक्ट, दिस इज इनकरेक्ट, बिकॉज रिट ज्यूरिसडिक्शन ऑफ हाई कोर्ट इज एक्चुअली वाइडर देन सुप्रीम कोर्ट, क्योंकि हाई कोर्ट के मतलब कि अंडर आर्टिकल 226 देयर आर 5 काइंड ऑफ रिट्स, और उसके अलावा भी यू कैन ऑल्सो इफ योर फंडामेंटल राइट इज वायलेटेड, यू कैन ऑल्सो claim your rights under that article. So this is a reason why it is actually wider than article 32. Question number 2, the term justice in article 38 of the Indian constitution is used to indicate, this is option number 4, social, economic and political justice. According to the constitution of India, any law made by the state which takes away or abridges the right conferred by part 3 shall be, so it is actually void to the extent of the contravention, this is given under article 13 44. Which article of the constitution of India safeguards one's right to marry the person of one's choice, this is option number 2, article 21. Fifth, which one of this is not a fundamental duty, this is option number 2, to promote international peace, this is not one of the fundamental duty. Question number 6, which of the following statement is true in respect to right to property, this is option number 2, it's a constitutional right. Question number 7, parliamentary privileges of the House of Parliament and the members and committees thereof include, so it includes what? It includes all of this: freedom of speech in Parliament, immunity from liability to any proceedings in any court in respect of anything said or any vote given by a member in Parliament and any committee, immunity from liability in respect of the publication by or under the authority of either House of Parliament of any report, paper, votes or proceedings. Question number 8, according to article 254 of the constitution of India, such portion of the state law as are repugnant to a central law in the concurrent sphere become invalid. The test of repugnancy was summarized in, so under article 254 deals with repugnancy of the laws, and this subject has been dealt in the case of M. Karunanidhi versus Union of India, 1979 case. Question number 9, under which schedule of the Constitution of India can the transfer of tribal land to private parties for mining be declared null and void? This is option number 2, 5th schedule. Question number 10, the Supreme Court of India exercises original jurisdiction in respect of any dispute of following nature. Again, this is all of this. Between the government of India and one or more states, between the government of India and any states or states on one side and one or more other states on the other, and between two or more states. 11. Now we will be having questions from CPC. where the decree is for partition of an undivided state assessed to the payment of revenue to the government, the partition of the state shall be, this option number one, made by collector. A files against B one suit on 6th of January 2020 and on the same grounds asking for same relief another on 18th of February 2020, suit filed in jurisdiction on merits before the suit filed in January could be decided. Examine the validity of statement that suit filed on January 6, 2020 is valid and res judicata will apply on the suit filed in February as it was filed later. But this statement is false and let me tell you why. First suit is filed on 6th of January and the next one is 18th of February 2020. But 18th February, the suit which was filed on 18th February 2020 has been decided and the suit which is filed on 6th of January 2020 is still pending. So in that case, even the case has been filed later on 6th of January, but still res judicata will apply because that judgment has come before 6th of January. Question number 13, which of the following statement is false? This one, no woman can be arrested or detained in the civil prison in execution of a decree except for the execution of a decree for the payment of money. No, this is not true because for the execution of a decree, a woman cannot be arrested. Then 14, if the sole plaintiff dies after the hearing of the suit was concluded, the suit shall, it shall continue as it is because the hearing is concluded. 15, in a suit filed in representative capacity, the suit can be withdrawn, compromised and abandoned by the plaintiff. This is option number 2, after notice to all the persons interested. 16, which of the following statement is false? This is option number 4, none of the statements are false because the given statements are true. Every suit by a minor shall be instituted in his name by person who in his such shall be the next friend. Then no temporary injunction shall be granted by a court under Order 39, Rule 1 or 2, CPC, where no perpetual injunction could be granted in view of the provisions of Section 38 and Section 41 of the Specific Relief Act. Then where it appears to the court to be just and convenient, the court may by order appoint a receiver of any property whether before or after decree. So all the given statements are true. 17. Suit for partition of joint immovable property shall be instituted in the court within the local limits of whose jurisdiction, this is option number 1, this property is situated, this given under section 16 of CPC. Then question number 18, what is the limitation to file application under order 9 rule 7 of CPC? Under under order 9 rule 7 of CPC, I mean this order actually deals with setting aside of an order and there is no such limitation. This is the reason why option number 4, none of this is the correct answer. 19, an application for the withdrawal of suit has been filed along with permission for grant of liberty to file fresh suit. In such an application, the court can, in that the court can reject or allow the application in toto. 20, under order 21 rule 37, before passing an order for the arrest or detention in the civil prison of judgment debtor court, in that option number 1 and 2 are correct, shall issue show cause notice instead of warrant for the arrest and may issue warrant of arrest if it is shown on affidavit that judgment debtor is about to abscond. 21, where an injunction has been granted without giving notice to the opposite party, the court shall make an endeavor to finally dispose of the application within 30 days from the date in which the injunction was granted. 22. Which among the following is not correct in relation to consideration of Order 21 Rule 90? The correct option is it must relate to conduct of sale alone, option number 2. So that will be the it is actually not correct because under Order 21 Rule 90 deals with the auction of the property can be set aside in case of material irregularity, and option number 2 is not the correct statement as given under this order. Question number 23, a suit in representative capacity can be filed by virtue of, this option number 3, under Order 1 Rule 8 of CPC. 24, where a suit is abetted or dismissed under Order 22 of CPC on the same cause of action, this option number 3, no fresh suit shall be brought. Question number 25, which of the following statement is true? This option number 3, according to section 9 of the CPC, the court shall have jurisdiction to try all suits of a civil nature, excepting suits of which their cognizance is either expressly or impliedly barred. So this is given under section 9 of CPC. Then question number 26 onwards, you will be having question from Transfer of Property Act. Which of the following can be considered implied surrender of the lease? Is option number 1, acceptance of a new lease taking effect during the continuance of the existing lease. 27, the right of a third person for maintenance cannot be enforced under section 39 against transferee who is, this option number 2, for consideration without notice of the right. Then question number 28, a lease of immovable property is not compulsorily registrable. This option number 4. So this is actually none of the above. A lease of immovable property is not compulsorily registrable. So in that case, none of the given options are true, because as already given in the question itself. Question number 29, the condition restraining absolute alienation is not void when it is for the benefit of lessor. Option number 1, where without delivering possession of the mortgage property, the mortgagor binds himself personally to pay the mortgage money and agrees that in the event of his failing to pay according to his contract, the mortgagee shall have a right to cause a mortgage property to be sold and the proceeds of sale to be applied in payment of the mortgage money. The transaction is called, option number 1, simple mortgage. 31. Transfer of Property Act, what is not a condition precedent for creation of an interest in favor of unborn person? This option number 3, prior interest should be for life. 32. According to the provision of the Transfer of Property Act, the easements cannot be transferred apart from the dominant heritage. Option number 3. 33. Where both parties are under mistake as to matter of the fact, the agreement will be option number 4. This is void. Now you will be having questions from Indian Contract Act. A guru's spiritual advisor induced a chela, his devotee, to give him the whole of his property to secure benefit to his soul in the next world. The gift shall be, this is voidable, because there is actually an undue influence. Because guru is actually in a dominant position and the chela, the devotee, is in an inferior position, and in that case, it is a contract which is induced by undue influence, and this is a reason why the contract would be voidable. Question number 35. Finder of a lost thing which is commonly the subject of sale may sell it with lawful charges of the finder in respect of the thing fine amount to. So in that case, 2/3 of its value he can take, the finder can take. Question number 36. A hires a carriage of B. The carriage is unsafe, though B is not aware of it, and A is injured. Then what will be consequence of it? This option number 2. B is responsible to A for injury. Every agreement in restraint of marriage of any person other than a minor is option number 3, is void. If a promisee accepts the anticipatory breach by promisor, then option number 3, the promisee need not perform his part of contract but entitled to claim damages from promissory without waiting till the date of performance. Then question number 39, a contract by which one party promises to save the other from loss caused to him by the conduct of the promisor himself or by the conduct of any other person. So this is called contract of indemnity, option number 3. 40. A promises to paint a picture for B up to December 31st and accepts an advance of Rs. 1000 after making of the contract. A's hands are chopped up in an accident on December 25. B is entitled to the refund of Rs. 1000 from A under which one of the following section? So this is actually option number 3, this is section 65. Question number 41. When due to fraud played by the parties, a contract in writing doesn't express its real intention, when appropriate remedy would be a suit for, this will be a suit for rectification of instrument. Question number 42. Specific performance of a contract cannot be enforced in favor of a person who has obtained substituted performance of contract under section 20. This statement is actually correct. Question number 43. Section 30 lays down that the court on adjudicating the rescission of a contract may require the party to whom such relief is granted. This is actually, there will be two options which are correct. to restore so far as may be any benefit which he may have received from the other party, and to make any compensation to him which justice may require. So here option both 1 and 2 will be correct. 44. A, while going abroad, leaves his furniture under the care of his friend B. B pledges the furniture to C in a suit filed by A under section 8 of the Specific Relief Act 1963. C may be compelled specifically to deliver the furniture to A. So the correct option would be option number 1. So under section 8, the person who is actually keeping the object on pledge can sue for it. 45. Which of the following infrastructure project is not mentioned in schedule of the Specific Relief Act? This is option number 3. 5-star hotel located within the city with population of more than 1 million. Then which of the following statement is false under Specific Relief Act? This is option number 4. None of this, because I am telling you all the given options are correct. An injunction cannot be granted to prevent the breach of a contract, the performance of which would not be specifically enforced. An injunction cannot be granted to prevent on ground of nuisance an act of which it is not reasonably clear that it will be a nuisance. And an injunction cannot be granted to prevent a continuing breach in which the plaintiff has acquiesced. So all the given options are correct. Question number 47. Negotiation for a settlement taking place between a claimant and a person against whom claim is made, if it doesn't debar the defendant from pleading a statute of limitation even though the negotiations have led to delay in bringing the action by the claimant. So these are the questions from the Limitation Act. Under section 21, a suit is deemed to have been instituted in case of a new plaintiff impleaded added. So here in this case, on the date on which the new plaintiff is impleaded, so from that date only the suit is deemed to have been instituted on the date on which the new plaintiff is impleaded. 49. The jurisdiction to grant exemption under section 14 of Limitation Act is given exclusively to this court of first instance. Under section 14 of the Limitation Act, there are certain exemptions given, like if a person actually prosecutes a case in a court in which it doesn't have the proper jurisdiction, so the day during which he has prosecuted the case would be exempted under section 14. 50. In a suit filed by the plaintiff, the defendant in his written statement has taken the objection of non-impleadment of necessary party. Despite such objection, the plaintiff continued the suit and the suit finally was decreed. At the first appellate stage, the plaintiff withdraws the suit with liberty to file a fresh one on the same cause of action and subsequently file a fresh suit. Thus, period spent by the plaintiff in the earlier suit under Section 14 of the Limitation Act is actually not liable to be excluded, as the plaintiff cannot be said to be prosecuted the earliest suit with due diligence and good faith. So only on the grounds of due diligence and good faith, the period during which the suit has been proceeded with can be excluded. But here in this case, he has actually withdrawn the suit, not prosecuted the suit in good faith. So this is a reason why it won't be liable to be excluded. Question number 51. So now the questions will be from MP Accommodation Act. MP Accommodation Act is nothing but the MP Rent Control Act. If a tenant makes deposit or payment as provided by section 13 clause 1 or 2, no decree or order shall be made by the court for the recovery of possession of accommodation on ground of this option number 1, section 12, clause 1, subclause A. MP Accommodation Control Act, where a landlord has acquired any accommodation but transfer no suit for eviction under section 12, clause 1, E or F, shall be maintainable till 1 year is over. Then question number 53, which of the following statement is correct under MP Accommodation Control Act? This option number 3, any land which is not used for agricultural purposes is covered under accommodation. Which of the following statement is false under MP Accommodation Control Act? This is question number 54. This option number 2, you have to choose the false one. Subject to anything to the contrary contained in any contract, no suit shall be filed in any civil court against for his eviction from any accommodation except on one or more of the grounds mentioned either in section 12 clause 1A or P or in the contract to the contrary. So this is not true. 55. MP Accommodation Control Act 1961 doesn't apply to option number 4, option number 2 and 3 both. This is property of municipal corporation used exclusively for non-residential purposes and property of government. 56. In which of the following matters jurisdiction of the civil court is not excluded? This is option number 4, partition of holding. Now these are the questions from MP Land Revenue Code. Who among the following is not a revenue officer? This is option number 3, revenue inspector. 58. Where a partition proceeding is filed before Tehsildar and a question of title is raised in it, the Tehsildar. So in that case, the Tehsildar shall stay the proceeding for 3 months to facilitate the institution of a civil suit for determination of question of title. Then a Bhumi Swami may transfer an interest in his land, question number 59. This is option number 1, by way of lease, even if the period of lease doesn't exceed 5 years at a time. 60. Choose the correct answer in relation to the following. A widow who is occupancy tenant can sublease the property. Now the questions will be from Indian Evidence Act. Question number 61. As per Act, a fact is said to be not proved. Very easy one. This is option number 4. When it is neither proved nor disproved. 62. Section 27 of the Indian Evidence Act is an exception to the rules enacted, option number 4, in section 24, 25 and 26 of the Indian Penal Code. So, under section 24, 25 amendment 26, the confession is not admissible, but section 27 is one of the exceptions. Question number 63, best rule evidence is exclusively associated with the rule laid down in this option number 4, section 91 of the Evidence Act, which actually deals with the documentary evidence, which is actually written and it has to be proved in the form of a written document only. Question number 64. A witness who is unable to speak gives his evidence in open court in the written form. It is oral evidence. 65. Which section makes anything said, done or written by an accused to a conspiracy relevant? As against conspirators in reference to their common intention. So this is option number 1, section 10 of Indian Evidence Act. Question number 66. Which of the following could be proved as dying declaration after the death of a person? This all of this FIR lodged by person who is deceased, that means the person who has died. Then statement of the person who is deceased to police recorded under section 161 CRPC and statement of the person deceased recorded by the executive magistrate. In this case, all of this. 67. Public documents are mentioned in option number 3, section 74 of Evidence Act. 68. The general rule is that the opinion or belief of a witness is irrelevant. Certain exceptions to this rule have been laid down in Indian Evidence Act. The sections containing these exceptions are, so exceptions are given in 45 to 51. Question number 69. Indian Evidence Act, which one of the following is not a public document? This is option number 4, a document forming the acts of an employee of an educational institution. So this is not a public document and rest the others are the public document. The document forming the acts of a sovereign authority is a public document. A document forming the acts of official body is a public document. And a document forming the acts of officer of government of India. Then question number 70, which of the following statement is not correct under Indian Evidence Act? This option number 3, plea of promissory estoppel shall be available even if an officer of the government acts outside the scope of his authority. No, in that case promissory estoppel won't be applicable if the government servant acts outside his duty. Then question number 71, test identification period under the law of evidence is what? This is actually corroborative evidence. Question number 72. The confession of an accused is only relevant against him. Which of the following section of the Indian Evidence Act 1872 is an exception to this rule? This is option number 4, section 28. Because under section 28, the confession can be proved against the person who is making it and also against the person who is involved with him. Question number 73. A retracted confession is option number 3. Cannot be made solely on the basis of conviction unless the same is corroborated. Retracted confession is nothing but at one instance the person is saying that he has committed the crime, and in the next instant he is saying that no, he hasn't given such confession. Question number 74. Necessity rule as to the admissibility of evidence is contained in this option number 2. Section 32 of Evidence Act, which also deals with dying declaration. I mean the evidence of those person which cannot be produced. Question number 75. In a murder case, before identification of the culprit, we wrote a letter of confession to the police officer. At the time of writing the letter, there was no suspicion cast on B. Choose the most appropriate answer from the following choices. So in that case, this option number 1 is inadmissible as it was made to a police officer. Question number 76. Preparation of which of the following offenses is punishable? So there are only two punishments. First is waging war against the state, and then waging war against the state and the dacoity. And in the rest of the other crime, the preparation is not punishable. Then question number 77. A man who regularly visits the Instagram page of a bikini model woman celebrity and also follows or commits the offense of option number 4. Man commits no offense. 78. Which of the following statement is false? This is option number 4. None of this. Because in all the options, the definitions are given and the definitions are total correct. Like theft is robbery. If in order to the committing of the theft, or in committing the theft, or in carrying away or attempting to carry away property obtained by the theft, the offender for that end voluntarily causes or attempts to cause to any person death or hurt or wrongful restraint or fear of instant death or of instant hurt or of instant wrongful restraint. So in that case, theft is also robbery. And similarly, the other definitions are also correct. Question number 79. A was bitten by B. In this act, A's shoulder was dislocated. B is liable for grievous hurt. Option number 2. 80. A finds a ring belonging to B on a table in the house which B occupies. Here the ring is in possession of B, and A, in good faith, believing that it belongs to him, takes it. A commits the offense of option number 4. None of this, because he had no dishonest intention. 81. A residing in Calcutta is agent for Z residing at Delhi. There is an express or implied contract between A and Z that all sums remitted by Z to A shall be invested by A according to Z's direction. Z remits 1 lakh rupees to A with directions to A to invest the same in company's paper. A, in good faith, believing that it will be more for Z's advantage to hold shares in the Bank of Bengal, disobeys Z's direction and buys shares in the Bank of Bengal for Z instead of buying company paper. Z suffers loss. A is liable for. So here actually A is not liable for anything, because again he has no dishonest intention. His intention was like A would be more profitable if he holds a share in Bank of Bengal. Question number 82. Where the accused caught hold of a girl, grabbed her by force by the side of the bushes, threw her down on the ground, removed her undergarments, got over her and attempted to penetrate, but before he could succeed, the girl started bleeding. So in this case, the accused was guilty of attempting rape. Question number 83. A shopkeeper, to protect his own money, says to B, who manages his business, sell nothing to Z unless he pays you ready money, for I have no good opinion for his honesty. A is not liable for defamation. Question number 84. A places men with firearms at the outlets of a building and tells Z that they will fire at Z if Z attempts to leave the building. What offense has A committed? Here, A has committed wrongful confinement and criminal intimidation. Question number 85. In which case offense under section 377 was held to be partially unconstitutional? Very easy one. This is option number 1, Navtej Singh Zoha versus Union of India. 86. A man who monitors the use by a woman of internet, email or any form of electronic communication commits the offense of, so he commits the offense of stalking. 87. A and B being joint owners of an elephant, A takes the elephant out of B's possession intending to use it. A then sells the elephant and appropriates the whole proceeds to his own use. What offense has he committed? This is option number 4, dishonest misappropriation. Then question number 88. A consults and agrees with B for poisoning C in order to murder him, for which B agrees to procure the poison but didn't procure. A and B are guilty of, this is criminal conspiracy to murder C and nothing else. 89. A blacksmith is seized by a gang of dacoits and forced by threat to instant death to take his tools and to open the door of B's house. The dacoits, 10 in number, loot B's money and jewel and kill B's son. A is guilty of which offense? His option number 3, his act is excusable, his act is covered under general exception because he did it under the threat of fear of death. So these are reasons why he won't be liable. Question number 90. A instigates B to burn Z's house. B sets fire to the house and at the same time commits theft of property there. Then A is guilty of which offense? Is option number 3, guilty of abetting the burning of house but is not guilty of theft. 91. In case of a warrant trial, this option number 4, only those offenses are included which are punishable with death, imprisonment for life or a term exceeding 2 years. 92. Under section 156 clause 3 of CRPC, the power to direct investigation is vested only in, this is option number 3, magistrate. 93. Magistrate can invoke power under section 156 clause 3 even at post-cognizance stage. It is held in option number 1, Vinubhai, Haribhai and others versus State of Gujarat and another. This is 2019 judgment and very important judgment. Question number 94. If the accused, though not of unsound mind, cannot be made to understand the proceedings of court, in that case may proceed with the proceeding. 95. Constitution bench of the Supreme Court resolved the conflict of its earlier decision regarding criminal court power in matter of adding additional accused in a criminal case in, this option number 1, this is Hardeep Singh versus State of Punjab and others. Then question number 96. A commits robbery on B and in doing so voluntarily causes hurt to him. Whether A may be separately charged with offences under section 323, 392 and 394, in that case, yes. Question number 97. When can an offence otherwise compoundable and not to be compounded? This option number 4, when the accused is by reason of a previous conviction liable either to enhanced punishment or to a punishment of a different kind for such offences. So such kind of offences are not compoundable. Question number 98. New chapter of plea bargaining was added in the Criminal Procedure Code by, this option number 1, Criminal Amendment Act 2005. So keep it in mind this question, because this question has been repeated many a times. 99. Any dispute relating to possession of immovable property is decided by, so it is decided by executive magistrate. Question number 100. A magistrate dismisses a complaint after inquiry holding that identity of the accused is not disclosed in complaint order of the magistrate is, this is option number 3, incorrect since it is not mandatory to describe the identity of the accused in complaint. So it is actually not mandatory. Question number 101. If in a complaint case it is made to appear to magistrate that an investigation by the police is in progress in relation to the same offence, which of the following orders a magistrate may pass under section 210 of the CRPC? So here the correct option is 2 and 3. Stay the proceeding of inquiry or trial on such complaint and call a report from the investigating officer. So it is only in such case in which the police has already started an investigation and a new complaint case is coming before the magistrate. So in that case, by virtue of section 210 of CRPC, the magistrate can stay the proceedings and call for a status report. Question number 102. Victim means and includes, this is all of this. A person who has suffered any loss or injury caused by reason of the act or omission for which the accused person has been charged, also his or her guardian or his or her legal heir. Question number 103. What persons may be charged jointly? So in this case, the correct option is all of these persons accused of the same offence committed in the course of the same transaction, then person accused of an offence and persons accused of abetment of or attempt to commit such offence persons accused of more than one offence of the same kind and persons accused of abetment of or attempt to commit such offence and persons accused of more than one offence of the same kind within the meaning of section 219 committed by them jointly within the period of 12 months. So there are certain kinds of punishment which can be charged jointly. So these are the kinds of punishment, like the punishments of this same nature and committed in the same course of transaction. Then question number 104, with regard to the place of inquiry or trial, which of the following statement is false? This is option number 4, where it consists of several acts done in different local areas. It may be inquired into or tried by a court having jurisdiction over the local area in which first of such acts was committed. So this is not true. Question number 105, any private person may arrest any person who in his presence commits option number 3, cognizable and non-bailable offence. 106, now the questions will be from Negotiable Instrument Act. A signs the instrument in the following terms. State the instrument which cannot be considered as promissory note. Like you have to choose an option which actually, by the face of it says that it is not a promissory note. I promise to pay B INR 500 7 days after my marriage with C. Option number 4 is actually the correct answer, because this actually in restraint of marriage, so it cannot be termed as a promissory note. 107, a court trying an offence under section 138 may order the drawer of the cheque to pay interim compensation, option number 1, in summon case when drawer plead not guilty. So at that time only, the drawer has to pay an interim compensation of 20% to the amount which is disputed. Question number 108, which of the following statement is false? If the person committing an offence under section 138 of the Negotiable Instrument Act is a company, so in that case, it is actually option number 4, none of this. So because all of the given options are true. Question number 109, Negotiable Instrument Act, where no rate of interest is specified in the instrument, interest on the amount due shall be calculated at the rate of this, option number 4, 18%. So in case if the no interest rate is specified in the instrument for the default of which a person has to pay, so in that case 18% will be considered. 110, amendment in section 148 of the Negotiable Instrument Act 1881 effective from 1st of September 2018 shall have a retrospective effect is held in the case of, this is option number 1, Surinder Singh Deswal versus Virendra Gandhi. So here in section 148 is nothing but, like, if a person is actually going for an appeal against the conviction, so in that case he has to pay a 20% of the amount which is actually ordered by that the court which is convicting to the amount of the compensation. Then I will be dealing with you the questions of general knowledge. River Narmada flows in which of the following direction? Question number 111, this is very easy, this is east to west. This is the only river which flows from east to west and among others, not the only one. 112, which of the waterfalls is situated in Madhya Pradesh? This is option number 4, all of these, Dhuadhar, Chachai and Kapildhara. 113, Lakshmibai National Institute of Physical Education is established in option number 3, Gwalior. 114, who was the Chief Justice of India when public interest litigation first time introduced in Indian judicial system? This is option number 4, Justice P.N. Bhagwati. 114, which one is not rabi crop? This is option number D, paddy, because option number 4, paddy, because paddy is a kharif crop. 116, the world famous rock art site in India is situated at, this Bhimbetka, option number 3. 117, boundary line drawn on map between India and China is known as option number 1, McMahon line. 118, which of the following has won the Nobel Prize 2020? This is option number 3, Food and Agriculture Organization. 119, Sputnik 5, which was in news recently, is related to option number 4, a vaccine. 120, which state is the largest producer of pulses in India according to latest figures? This is option number 1, Madhya Pradesh. 121, where was freedom fighter Tatya Tope hanged in Madhya Pradesh? This is option number 2, Shivpuri. 122, Satyamev Jayate is taken from which? This is option number 3, Mundak Upanishad. 123, artist Sri बेओहार राम मनोहर सिन्हा हु इलस्ट्रेटेड द प्रियम्बल टू द ओरिजिनल कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया इज रिलेटेड टू विच डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ मध्य प्रदेश इज ऑप्शन नंबर टू जबलपुर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 124 द बुक नेम थ्री टिकट्स इन पार्लियामेंट इज कलेक्शन ऑफ द स्पीचेस ऑफ दिस ऑप्शन नंबर वन ए बी वाजपेयी. 125 एंटोमोलॉजी इज द साइंस दैट स्टडीज ऑप्शन नंबर टू इट स्टडीज इंसेक्ट्स. क्वेश्चन नंबर 126 इंडिपेंडेंट इंडिया वॉन इट्स फर्स्ट ओलंपिक हॉकी गोल्ड इन ऑप्शन नंबर फोर दिस इज 1948. 127 अमजद अली खान इज एसोसिएटेड विथ विच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इंस्ट्रूमेंट दिस ऑप्शन नंबर वन सरोद. 128 विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट अ चीफ ऑर्गन ऑफ द यूनाइटेड नेशंस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन दिस ऑप्शन नंबर वन इंटरनेशनल लेबर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. 129 यूएन अडॉप्टेड विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग रेजोल्यूशन स्पॉन्सर्ड बाय इंडिया दिस ऑप्शन नंबर टू Reducing nuclear danger and conventional prohibition of the use of nuclear weapons. And the last question 130, which of the following tiger reserves was awarded with the status of UNESCO biosphere reserve? This option number 3, Panna tiger reserve. Then I will be having questions from computer knowledge. There are 10 questions. Information on a computer is stored as option number 3, this is digital data. 132. In computer networking, FTP stands for option number 3, file transfer protocol. 133. Which of the following statement is false? This option number 4, none of this. Because let us read. Operating system is a software which performs all the basic tasks like file management, memory management, process management. Then establishment of communication, interaction in between hardware and software is called interface. And 3. Software may broadly be categorized into system software, application software and programming software. 134. Assembler is a program that translates the program from option number 2 assembly to machine. Device 135. Device which is used to read a mark sense answer sheet of a particular test is known as facsimile machine. Is known as character or mark recognition device. Now and I'm giving you an example like this examination is going to conduct in pen and paper mode and you would be asked to fill the OMR sheet. So how that your answer sheet will be checked? So there is a machine called character or mark recognition device in which your OMR sheet will be put in and that's how your marks will be calculated. 136, which of the following is not used as secondary storage? This is option number 1, semiconductor memory. 137, which one is a open source operating system? This is option number 2, Linux. 138, Miracast is what? Option number 1, wireless content streaming technology. 139, when discussing technology, a hotspot is option number 2, a place served by public wireless access. 140, shortcut for displaying the full page as they are printed. So the shortcut is control plus F2. Now I will be having questions from English knowledge. There are total number of 10 questions. 141, out of the given alternatives, choose the one which can be substituted for the sentence, a song embodying religious and sacred emotions. This known as hymn. 142, a past master is a person who, option number 4, is thorough in a chosen field. Then question number 143, select the option that is nearest in meaning to the bold word. The portal will help victim and complainants to anonymously report cybercrime. So the synonym will be incognito, option number 1. 144. Choose the exact meaning of the idiom and phrase. Mrs. Hasmi has been in the blues for the last several weeks. Has been in the blues. So blues means what? Option number 3, depressed. 45. Give one word substitution. One who pretends to be somebody else called. Option number 2, imposter. 146, impasse means what? It means deadlock, option number 3. 147, change this sentence from direct to indirect speech. I said to him, why are you working so hard? So, the direct speech will be, sorry, it is in direct speech. The indirect speech would be, I asked him why he was working so hard. Question number 148, choose the one word which can be substituted for the given sentence, that which cannot be corrected. This option number 4, incorrigible. 149, find out the correct antonyms of the word diminish. This is option number 3, increase. 150, choose the exact meaning of the idioms and phrase. Bird's eye view, it means what? It means to a general view from above. So this is the 150 questions and I have dealt with you the entire 150 questions. और अगर आपको इससे related अगर कोई doubt है तो you can comment the same in the comment section below. And sorry guys that I went too fast because I had to deal a total number of 150 questions. और वो मतलब कि इतना आसान था नहीं. अगर मैं धीरे धीरे करवाती तो time ज़्यादा लग जाता है ना. Already time ज़्यादा लग भी गया है. So I would request you to watch the video till the end. एक ही questions आप इसे ध्यान से देखिए. And also do not forget to like, share and subscribe us. So till we meet the next time, thank you and have a nice day.